All right, so hello everyone. We're at Gingerman Rceway. Well, we are. I am. Took a couple of days off work, and we're Tuesday and Wednesday this week doing Mohawk Track Experience. So Gingerman's west of Michigan. This is where grid life Midwest happens. Been here a few times. Been here a few times with the Shelby. So first time since the engine blew up in Grattan, I think it was 2 years ago. So first time on track, so we're gonna see how I do, because I'm gonna be a bit rusty. And then I got a few upgrades on the car with the new front splitter, the dive planes, a bit more aero, different camber settings, so we'll see how it does. I'm just camping for the weekend. Most of the guys have there's huge trucks and stuff like this over there. People have massive trailers. For some of them, it's more like a day in the hotel, but I'm old school, I guess. I'm cheap. I can afford the car, but nothing else. And then we've got Advans Group is already running. I booked in intermediate for today, because I haven't been on track for 2 years. So I'm gonna take it easy. And then I'm running Advans tomorrow, so we'll see how it goes. I've got the camera in the car, so I'm gonna try to film some laps. Initially I was thinking I'm only gonna film tomorrow, but knowing how the last three track days ended with the car being on the trailer, I might just film today, you never know.
Thank you.
right, we're two sessions in. First one was a little bit messy for me behind the wheel and people on track. The solo 2 deal, which is this in here, did not record anything, and everybody was running one or was having the issue. I think the GPS wasn't picking up the start finish line on the track, so it gave me basically an 18 minute lap, just a single big lap, so pretty useless. But we figured it out, went on the laptop with some of the guys with Capaldi, went in the trailer, plugged it in, were able to actually upload a configuration where I actually get data from the OBD port on the car. So I actually get my RPM and my oil temp on there, and then I have my best lap time, my current lap time, and my difference between my current lap time and my best. So it's pretty good, it gives me some information. Honestly, out there in intermediate group, there's quite a few guys that are not super fast. You'll see on the video, there's some that are completely off track. Like I saw a couple guys with Mustangs and an FRS that almost went off track in front of me. I think they were just looking in the mirror a little bit too much. But other than that, the car's doing well. I was surprised, like first session, the tires, the Potenzas. Yokohama Advans. It felt like they were overheating, and they were kind of like falling over, like on the shoulder. So end of the session, I pulled in, looked at the tires. They were actually pretty good. So they're actually run pretty well for 280 tread wear. They could have a little bit more grip, obviously. It's not an R888R or a slick, far from that, but it's keeps it fun. Like I can slide the car around. When I want to have fun, I can have fun. When I want to push it and be on the line and be a bit more precise, I can do that too. So that's pretty good. Engine is holding up. It doesn't go above 90 degrees Celsius. I don't speak freedom units, sorry. It stays pretty cool. Brakes are a little bit on the soft side, not at the pedal, but I'm running just stock pads on the gyro discs. And honestly, I should be running track pads. So I lose a little bit of bite about halfway through the braking zones when they start overheating and before you start actually trail braking. So it's something to manage. I'm not pushing the brake zones like crazy. I'm not going for a lap time or anything, even though I did 147 I think in the previous session.
last few sessions of the day are done. I packed up and I'm gonna head back home, because to be honest, I'm tired. It was getting pretty hot in the afternoon, and quite honestly, without the correct tires, the way I'm pushing the car is just starting to slide around quite a bit and just fighting grips. So I think in the end I did a 147.05, which is a decent lap, but honestly, on Cup 2s or something like this, I'd be in the low 143 probably. So it was a good day anyway, you know, didn't break anything, didn't damage anything. Missed a gear once, but managed to not put it in first instead of third, so kind of saved the engine there. But but yeah, I was starting to do some mistakes like this at the end of the day, so I don't think it's really very smart to do another day tomorrow. Definitely need some track brake pads and track tires, because everything else now is really well dialed in and the car is really fast. But I'm kind of to the limits of the grip. So that's a wrap for today. And goodbye, Gingerman. We'll definitely come back. I wanna bring the Cuda here at some point, and I absolutely want to bring the Twingo, because I think it's going to be a really cool track for the Twingo. We'll be back, but now we got to focus on getting the Cuda and fixing a couple more things on the Cuda, sorting out a couple of things, and then driving it hopefully to Dream Cruise, getting it on Woodward this week or something like this. So we'll see. All right, see you everyone.